Let us all be seated. Ilang araw na lang po, next week na, andyan na ang ating pinakahihintay na Santo Papa Pope Francis. Excited na ba kayo?
Yes!
Excited na ba ang Pilipinas? Yes. Let us now begin our eighth papal visit media briefing with the topic Luneta Mass with the chairman of the Committee on Information and Media Relations, no other than Bishop Mylo Vergara.
Magandang hapon po at Happy New Year sa inyong lahat. You know, Luneta stands witness to various significant and historical events in the lives of the Filipino people. Drops of blood that signified martyrdom lies in its vast land. The Quirino Grandstand situated in Luneta has served a lot of presidential oath-taking ceremonies, welcome ceremonies for foreign dignitaries, political rallies, campaigns, concerts, prayer rallies, and public masses, most especially the papal masses of Blessed Paul VI, St. John Paul II, and now His Holiness Pope Francis. In this particular papal visit, the Quirino Grandstand has been undergoing renovations for security and practical reasons for the January 18 Luneta Mass of His Holiness Pope Francis at 3:30 in the afternoon. And to make it more special and memorable, the altar and papal chair have been articulately designed by a priest architect, also present here, and designer, Father Alexander Bautista, who patterned his designs from a common Philippine plant, anahaw, to add a special Filipino touch to it. In this particular occasion, let the expected crowd be 5 million or more, to be reminded with what Pope Francis said, and I quote, "We must not forget that true power at whatever level is service, which has its luminous summit on the cross. With great wisdom, Benedict XVI reminded the church many times that for man, authority is often synonymous with service, humility, love. It means to enter into Jesus' logic, who bends down to wash the feet of the apostles and who says to his disciples, 'You know that the rulers of the Gentiles lord it over them. It shall not be among you. In fact, the motto of your assembly, no, it shall not be among you, but whoever would be great among you must be your servant, and whoever would be first among you must be your slave.' As the coming of His Holiness Pope Francis approaches, may we all welcome him with spiritual readiness, and may his special gift of simplicity, sincerity, truth, mercy, and compassion linger and bind us as one solid Filipino nation. May his holy presence embrace us all, his faithful brethren, as one united children of God, renewed in faith and wisdom, soaked in mercy and compassion even after His Holiness Pope Francis has left our blessed land behind. Thank you.
Thank you, Bishop Mylo, for that introduction, for the beautiful grand celebration of Pope Francis at the Luneta. Let us now hear a statement from the Executive Secretary of the Steering Committee, Father Rufino June Sescon.
Good afternoon to everyone. It is said that the culminating activity will really leave a lasting mark, a lasting impression. And in the papal visit, the culminating activity would be the Mass at the Luneta. And it is there that we really expect His Holiness Pope Francis to deliver his message to all the Filipinos. Because in most of the previous events of the papal visit, it would be addressed to certain sectors, certain segments of society. But this Mass at the Luneta is for everyone. So this, we expect him really to deliver his message to the Filipino people. And this activity highlights the joint efforts of government and church. And we are very appreciative and grateful to the government for their utmost cooperation in making sure really that this activity will be peaceful and orderly, and of course, it will show to the world also the spirit and the face of the Filipino people. And that is why all government agencies and all the church committees have been activated, you know, for this grand activity. And as it has been the custom of the Holy Father in Rome, and hopefully with the help really of security, so he will go around before if there are roads, no? But with security has assured us that there will be enough roads, so the Holy Father will go around the Luneta before he celebrates the Mass, and then by 3:30 begin the Mass. There is a special section for certain sectors of the church and society, and because the Holy Father would really want to meet certain people in our society, like for example we'll be having 500 persons with disabilities, 500 from the urban poor, 500 from the religious, 500 from the lay leaders, and also the youth under the pastoral care of the church, like those who are undergoing rehabilitation, those in the orphanages, and also, of course, we also have representatives from the government and the diplomatic corps. So we expect around 2,500 priests to concelebrate, and then 200 bishops, and then it will be elaborated later on by the liturgy side. The choir, we have 1,000 members of the choir and 200 orchestra. So this is the grand activity, and we hope to hear and listen to the message of Pope Francis.
Thank you, Father Jun Sescon. No? So exciting yung ating culminating activity. Sabi nga, saving the best for last. No? 20 years ago, alam po natin yung Mass ni St. John Paul II, 20 years ago, ilang million yun, no? Naging record all over the world. How many millions went to Luneta? Ngayon kaya, ilang million ang darating sa culminating Mass ni Pope Francis? Pakinggan naman natin ngayon, ano ang magiging liturgia, the Mass of this Luneta event, coming from the one in charge of the liturgy, Father Carmelo Arada Jr. Father Jack.
Good afternoon. The concluding Mass of the Holy Father, the day of the concluding Mass of the apostolic visit, will fall on the Feast of the Santo Niño, a proper feast in the Philippines. So before the Mass begins, devotees from the Archdiocese of Cebu will lead the people in the sinulog rhythm and dance. That is why all those who will participate in the Mass will be requested to bring their images of the Santo Niño to join the sinulog dance. The liturgical celebrations of the visit of the Holy Father were all prepared in collaboration with the Office of the Papal Master of Liturgical Celebrations. A series of meetings, ocular inspections, and consultations were held together with the Vatican liturgical team. The Mass will be in English. It will follow the new translation of the third edition of the Roman Missal. The prayers will be from the votive Mass of the Holy Name of Jesus, and the readings from the proper of the Santo Niño. The prayers and the readings invite us to encounter Jesus in living out His own compassion and mercy towards our brothers and sisters in need and poverty, in suffering, loneliness, and hopelessness. It was Pope Francis himself who said, "To meet the living God, we must tenderly kiss the wounds of Jesus in our hungry people, in the sick, in the imprisoned brothers and sisters." And like the Apostle Thomas, our life will only be changed when we touch Christ's wounds present in the poor, the sick, and the needy. The path to our encounter with Jesus is His wounds, and there is no other. The profession of faith, yun pong sumasampalataya, will be led by the Holy Father. So maririnig po natin ang Santo Papa na magsabing, "Sumasampalataya ako." The intercessions will be prayed in the different Filipino languages. No? Hiligaynon, Kapampangan, Ilocano, Cebuano, Waray, Bicolano. The response will be in Tagalog and in English. The acclamations are set in music employing also multilingual responses. At the conclusion of the liturgical celebration, candles will be lighted. So everybody again is also requested to bring their own candles. It will be lighted as we sing "Tell the World of His Love." The Holy Father will then send us to our own families, communities, and workplaces to be instruments of God's mercy and compassion. The readers for the celebration will be a blind person from the Ministry of Persons with Disabilities of the Archdiocese of Manila and a grade 7 student of the Our Lady of Guadalupe Minor Seminary. The responsorial psalm will be led by a representative from the youth sector. Three families will bring to the Holy Father the vessels of bread and wine during the presentation of the gifts. As said earlier by Father June, the choir and the orchestra are composed of about 1,000 members from the different parishes and communities of the dioceses in the Philippines. The mass songs were composed by Father Manuling Francisco. Again, it is multilingual, the different languages. Musically, the multilingual mass setting fuses both Western music and Filipino indigenous rhythms, such as the Kalinga rhythm from the north and the Singkil rhythm from the south, and the Filipino melodic and chord patterns, such as the Kondiman of Central Luzon. The aim of all of this is to create a national consciousness of unity despite diverse cultural expressions and to foster a sense of unity with the Universal Church. Thank you.
Thank you, Father Jack, for that beautiful rundown of the event of this beautiful mass of Pope Francis. Alam po natin, ito'y kapistahan ng Santo Niño, third Sunday of January. No, at ang Santo Niño po ay talaga isang special feast in the Philippines only. No, dahil nga yung the most popular image of Jesus Christ in the Philippines is the Santo Niño. Kaya sana makikita million-million images ni Santo Niño makikita natin. Pwede na sa Guinness 'yan. No, yan. Abangan natin 'yan, ano? At maganda rin po pakinggan natin yung nag-design, the architect designer ng altar of the Luneta Mass, no? At siya rin po ang architect designer ng papal chair na gagamitin ni Pope Francis, no? Magiging relic na yun sa Luneta Mass, no? Siya po yung from the Diocese of Tarlac. Let us hear from Father Alex Bautista. Thank you.
Good afternoon, everybody. In the design consideration for the liturgical space we're going to prepare for the Mass in Luneta, the concept is to be to serve the liturgical for liturgical purpose, no, initially, and then to have a Filipino character and to reflect the simplicity of the Vicar of Christ. That is why the altar table is actually, the form comes from a praying hand to begin with, and then you can see a floating element which is the tabletop, lifting the gifts and the offerings of the altar. And it is replete of symbol, like the anahaw leaf, symbolizing the strength of the Filipino people. We know that anahaw leaf is the Philippine national leaf. And it will have an alternating motif of cross with orb. It's Christ embracing the world. And then doves, they represent souls. And also you will see flutings representing the bamboo element. And the marble top will be from Romblon. So if you cannot bring the Pope to go around the Philippines, we will bring elements from the Philippines close to the Pope. Like the linen, of course, the linen will be a white cloth, but then the fall will be from piña cloth, no, from Laguna. And the papal chair will have, of course, an anahaw leaf motif and the papal seal, but also it will have a Filipino good shepherd, and it will say, ang mabuting pastol, and then you will see elements like bayabas guava tree because it has a healing quality. So all of these, no, we try to blend, no, in the design, including the landscaping, no, which will be done by Rachikuna, and we coordinated. We will not use, you will not see any flower, no, to begin with. We will use San Francisco plants, very common in rural backyards. And because San Francisco plant, they need sun, no, to have its color. So it's like the faith of the people, no, from the sun, from the light, no, Christ who is the light of the world. So yun ang the whole concept. It will be a native element, no, of Aruga. No, you will see everything as a concept, no, the Aruga. And you will see the image of Our Lady of Nuestra Señora de Guia, which is very the image of Our Lady in Manila. And she appeared on a pandan leaf, so the pandan plant will be used also. And the image of Santo Niño, courtesy of the San Agustinian Fathers of Intramuros. Well, tinalak, we will use tinalak in another venue to bring Mindanao also. No? And we will have singkab, which is a Kawayan arts and craft of Bulacan to decorate the canopy. So basically, we will bring the Philippines to the Pope if he cannot go around the Philippines. So in the Filipino context will always be incorporated in the design. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Father Alex. So alam po natin that the Luneta Mass, the culminating Mass of Pope Francis, will be a mega event. Definitely millions will go and flock to Luneta. Now, how are we going to prepare for that? And how is the government going to prepare for that? Pakinggan po natin from the Presidential Communications Operations Office, Secretary San Coloma.
Magandang hapon po sa inyong lahat. Bayanihan para sa kaayusan at kaligtasan sa pagdalaw ng mahal na Santo Papa. Yan po ang panawagan ng ating pamahalaan sa lahat ng Pilipino. Tuwing dadalaw ang mahal na Santo Papa sa ating bansa, binibigyan tayo ng pagkakataon na itanghal ang ating kabutihan, kagandahan ng kalooban, at tibay ng pananampalataya. Ipakita po natin muli sa buong daigdig ang tulad ng ipinakita natin sa EDSA noong 1986. Kahit libo-libo ang nagpapahayag ng paninindigan, kaya nating mapanatili ang pagiging mahinahon, mapagbigay at paggalang sa isa't isa. Gagawin ng pamahalaan ang nararapat upang tiyakin ang kaayusan at kaligtasan ng lahat. Ngunit aasa din kami sa buong pusong pakikisa at kooperasyon ng lahat upang mairaos natin ng maayos, matiwasay at ligtas ang pagdalaw ng mahal na Santo Papa, Pope Francis. Salamat po.
Thank you, Secretary Coloma. Alam naman natin, pag maraming tao, baka may mga mahilo, magkasakit, o maaksidente, we have to be prepared for that. Pakinggan naman natin, from the Department of Health, Assistant Secretary, Dr. Jerry Bayugo.
The Department of Health is the as part of the Committee on Security and Public Order. And for the Pope's visit in the Philippines, the DOH is the designated task unit for medical and health concerns of the faithful and devotees. And we have been making preparations since the second half of 2014 for this important role. And our provisions have included the following. Number one, first aid in all areas of engagement, which in Pope Francis Manila's schedule includes arrival at Villamor Air Base and visits at the congregations of the faithful in UST, Manila Cathedral, SM Mall of Asia, and Quirino Grandstand. In the Quirino Grandstand Luneta Mass on January 18, more than 100 first aiders will be mobilized and stationed in several medical tents in strategic areas. These first aiders are trained on basic life support, standard first aid, advanced cardiac life support, emergency medical technician course, mass casualty management, and incident command system. Number two, transportation and ambulance. These are for the devotees who would need this kind of assistance. There are an adequate number of ambulances with their corresponding teams provided by the Department of Health, other government agencies, the Philippine Red Cross, and volunteer groups. They are ready to provide services beyond first aid and to conduct patients to hospitals if necessary. Number three is coordination with the receiving hospitals. All the DOH hospitals in Metro Manila are ready to receive and the patients transported from the congregation sites. In addition, we have also coordinated with several local government hospitals as well as private medical centers in the area. This early, we are thankful to our partners in the communities and private sector in helping the department firm up its plans for the health and safety of the faithful and devotees. We are together in prayer with the Filipino nation for the success of His Holiness' visit in the country. And if I may add, our tips for the devotees, please bring plenty of water, prevent dehydration. You know? Number two, have concern for the safety of others. Do not push or shove other devotees. Number three, instead of umbrella, we encourage you to bring fans, pangtakip sa ulo kung mainit, or raincoat kung uulan, so as not to obstruct the view of others. In case of emergency, keep calm and do not panic. Remember, help is always nearby. And for those with chronic illnesses, with maintenance medication, please bring your medicines with you. And should you need medical attention, please go to the nearest first aid station. And we would like to encourage the pregnant women who are due to deliver during the month na baka pwedeng sa television na lang po or somewhere not crowded. And if you want to bring small children, kung po pwede, wag yung mga infants. But as a rule, we would like to recommend that one adult, one child, so that maiwasan yung nawawalang bata. And please, no firecrackers, no alcohol. Thank you po.
Wow, napakagandang paalala sa atin from Dr. Jerry Bayugo of the Department of Health. No, health is wealth, kaya mag-ingat po tayo. Tayong mga pupunta sa Luneta, let us always be health conscious and security conscious. At syempre, before we go to the open forum, the exciting part of our press briefing, let us hear some announcement first from Bishop Mylo Vergara.
It has been asked from me who are the personalities in the papal entourage, no? And I'm giving the announcement right now, no? It was actually released to me by the nunciature. What I will be reading is only half of it because the total number of the papal entourage is 32 persons, no? This doesn't include the Vatican media accredited personnel who will be joining the papal flight, which accounts to around 80 persons. No, when you talk of the papal entourage, this also includes the personalities who are necessary for each event who will be accompanying the Holy Father. No. Of course, His Eminence Cardinal Luis Antonio Tagle, His Excellency Monsignor Socrates B. Villegas, the President of the CBCP, His Excellency Monsignor Giuseppe Pinto, the Apostolic Nuncio in the Philippines, and his two secretaries, Reverend Monsignor Chibuque Onyegala, the Counselor of the Apostolic Nunciature, and Reverend Siamus Patrick Horgan, the Counselor of the Apostolic Nunciature. So these five personalities are already here. Now let me read the other, of which is part of the 15. The first one, of course, is His Eminence Cardinal Pietro Parolin, the Secretary of State of His Holiness. His Eminence Cardinal Fernando Filoni, the Prefect of the Congregation for the Evangelization of Peoples. If you recall, Cardinal Filoni was formerly the Apostolic Nuncio to the Philippines. And then His Eminence Cardinal Robert Sara was just named Prefect of the Congregation of Divine Worship. His Excellency Monsignor Giovanni Angelo Becciu, Substitute of the Secretariat of State, Monsignor Mark Gerald Miles, Official of the Secretary of State, Dr. Alberto Gasbari, Chief Organizer of the Papal Visit, who has visited us twice, no, just to coordinate particulars for the apostolic journey to Sri Lanka and the Philippines. Father Federico Lombardi, SJ, the Director of the Holy See Press Office. You will be familiar with him because our next press conferences from the 15th to the 18th will be with Father Lombardi. No? Monsignor Dario Eduardo Vigano, Director of the Vatican Television Center, CTV. Professor Giovanni Maria Vian, Editor-in-Chief of La Osservatore Romano, and Professor Patricio Polisca, personal doctor of the Holy Father. The other 16 belongs to the group of the Vatican radio personnel, Vatican press, the Vatican aid, and of course, the Vatican security, which includes the Swiss guards. No? So we will be publishing this in our website, no, so that you can download them for your information giving to the public.
Thank you, Bishop Mylo, for that detailed update. Now, let us now have more details and going to more concrete situations and issues. We will now have our open forum. Just raise your hand and introduce yourself and throw your question. Of course, my dear friend.
Noli. I'm Noli M. Suwan, private practitioner. I'm just concerned about the mass at the Luneta because it will start at about before 4. 3:30, and then it will go on to the darkness of the night. Though. Are we properly lighted?
Tinitiyak po sa atin ni Secretary Rogelio Babe Singson ng Department of Public Works and Highways na lahat noong infrastrukturang kailangan, kabilang na yung sapat na liwanag o ilaw sa buong premises ng Luneta Grandstand at Rizal Park ay sinasaalang-alang ng ating pamahalaan.
Thank you.
Okay, we will be well lighted. Kitang-kitang liwanag ng sanlibutan. Okay, let's have more
I'm Brother questions. Nur Salas Perez. I'm a third order Franciscan Friars of the Immaculate. But I am a Kapampangan. Okay, kanina po si Reverend Father Sescon Jr. mentioned the composition of the marginalized religious group. I was mag-e-excite sana ako na masama ang mga victims of calamities. Wala ho dun sa listahan. Without the media knowing, in Pampanga we have about 500 families. We take care of them. They are from Tacloban, Leyte. We gave them shelter, food, even jobs. They are now lantern makers. In Metro Manila, because I'm with the city government of Manila as a consultant to the mayor sa maralit ang Tagalunsod, marami din ho ang mga taga Samar, Tacloban, Leyte. Bakit hindi natin sila isama doon? So that ang karanasan ko sa kanila, this is nature's way of mentioning kung ano ang gusto niya dito sa mundong ito. At they believe na ang mga pagsubok sa kanila ay hindi makadiyos. And we are trying to bend those heart na hindi kagagawan ng puong may kapalang kalamidad at pagkasawin ng kanilang mga pamilya. Let's give them hope. Waiter ho sila, waitress, okay. Kung ano-ano ang trabaho na, nila dito.
Nakalimutan ko na pong
makabuo ng pamilya uli, okay. Makapagtayo ng mga pamamahay na disente. Wala po silang mga bahay.
Nakalimutan ko lang po banggitin kanina na sinulatan din po lahat ng mga obispo, no? Ang lahat ng dioceses na magpadala ng kanilang mga kinatawan. At kasama dun sa sulat liham po ni Archbishop Villegas na ang ipadala na bukod sa mga paring magko-celebrate sa misa ay ipadala yung mga sektor na tingin nila ay kailangan higit, no, ng makakita. Kaya nga sabi kong kailangan pang bigyan ng pamasahe, no, ng diocese itong mga kinatawan ng mga dioceses, no, ay iyon yung ipadala po. Kaya kasama po doon yung binabanggit nyo pong mga sektor, kaya nasa ang mga obispo po ang titingin po, at alam naman po natin siyempre ang isang sektor na nangangailangan higit ng makarinig kay Pope Francis ay yung mga nasalanta. Although of course alam po natin yung sa Visayas ang concentration po noon ay yung sa Tacloban po, dahil mas economical din po na doon sila magpunta. Kaya mainly po yung Visayas and Mindanao, sila rin po ay nabigyan ng imbitasyon in-encourage sila na doon pumunta. Pero gayon pa man, kahit to yung Archdiocese of Palo and lahat sa Samar at Leyte ay inanyayahan pa rin magpadala ng kinatawan dito sa Luneta. Kaya masasabi naman po natin na lahat po, no, maging yung binabanggit nyo pong naapektuhan ng mga kalamidad ay nakonsidera at nabigyan din ng imbitasyon.
Thank you very much, Father June. Meron pa po tayo dyan. Yes. Cara?
Ako po si Cara David sa Channel 7. Asst Bayugo, confirm ko lang po yung first aiders. Sa 100 po na first aiders or 100 na first aid stations?
20 first aid stations and 20 ambulances for the Luneta activity alone. Then yung mga volunteers na pwedeng magbit-bit, kunwari crowded, ikikerry by stretcher, we have 120 identified people already.
Kasha na po ba yun, Ase, kung 5 million po ang darating? I mean, halimbawa po kapag kunyari po pista ng Nazareno, gaano po ba karami yung mga first aid stations na karaniwan pong nakakalat doon? Tapos aside from yung mga ipapadala po ng DOH, meron din po bang ipapadala or nakipag-coordinate na rin po ba sa inyo yung iba pang mga NGOs like yung mga Red Cross, yung mga iba pang mga rescue groups, mga ganyan po?
Yeah, for the Quirino activity doon sa Luneta, actually isang particular group that we have tapped is yung Nazareno volunteers. So sanay na rin sila kasi mag-manage ng medyo crowded and faithful, similar ano, ah, hindi mo mapipigil, baka magsiksikan din, but they are very much familiar to manage crowd like this. So we took it the point na itong mga expert na Nazareno volunteers will be mobilized in this activity. Hindi naman DOH, it's lang Red Cross also is part, and other volunteers from Metro Manila. Hindi naman DOH lang yung gumalaw dito. Even private hospitals are also part of the teams, pati yung mga ambulances. So we have 20 stations. We have 20 ambulances with teams. Meron pa, may tao sa station, may tao pa rin sa teams, plus the mobile na 120 volunteers. All of these are first aiders. All of these are trained and well-versed with the first aid management.
Kaya mahalaga doon sa mga pupunta sa Luneta, malaman nila kung nasan ang location ng mga first aids natin. Ano? First aid lang.
May layout na sa plano ng ng organizers yan.
Yeah. Si Father Alex po prepared the master plan for the Luneta, so all with DPWH for the communion station,
portalets,
health station, portalets, yes. Lahat po ng ano po ng mga important, yes, places and locations.
Yung mga emergency, yung mga call of nature. Father Alex, gaano karami pong portalets are we expecting to be placed strategically? In
Around 400 portalets will be distributed.
400 portalets. Apo.
Actually, we're preparing the master plan because the plan has many layers. Huh. Yung sa communion station, like yung first aid station, lahat yun kinonsider. We're suggesting to, also to come up with the flyer just to see the toilets and the ganyan for people to, parang it's a loose leaf para to guide. And then I think the screens will be helpful also, no, to from time to time show the plan of the Luneta. Yes, 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 ma'am. Yes, ma'am. The communion corridors are located properly, so for proper communion, receiving of communion.
Father Jack, what about the communion stations? How many are we going to have?
We have 20 communion chapels, 5,000 communion distributors for the whole of, and then we will have also 5,000 communion ushers. So ang magiging palatandaan po ng communion distribution, meron pong communion umbrellas. White communion umbrellas with the logo of the Holy Father and of the Papal Visit.
Magagaling sa Baguio, yung 5,000 ciborium. Pamunta na from Baguio.
Tama po. From Baguio, 5,000 ciborium.
Kaya 5,000 special Eucharistic ministers will distribute communion. Okay? Estimate nga natin. Marami nang kasabi. Secretary San Coloma, what is your estimate? Scenario building, ilan ho ba ang estimated na pupunta sa Luneta?
Kung ang pagbabatayan po natin ay yung pagdalaw ng mahal na Santo Papa, Pope John Paul II, noong January of 1995, ang naalala ko po na figure na minimension noon ay 5 million. Ngayon, pansinin po natin, subject din naman ito doon sa physical parameters of the location. Hindi naman po nag-expand ang Rizal Park in the last 20 years. Kung ano po yung physical layout niya nung 20 years ago, halos pareho pa rin. No? At merong iba't ibang mga estimate na para doon sa, depending on the assumption on how many people will occupy a square meter. No? Isa po sa mga konsiderasyon yan na siguro titignan natin na, or titiyakin po natin na hindi naman magsisiksikan o magigit-gitan. No? Dahil to begin with, maapektuhan po yung comfort factor, no? Kung masyado nagsisiksikan at meron ding safety repercussions. No? So ilalagay lang po natin sa ayos na tama lang yung may comfortable physical space siguro sa pagitan ng mga mananampalataya na mag-a-attend ng misa. Pero yung po kasing pinaka-main area ng Rizal Park, kahit na sinasabi natin 5 million, hindi naman yun makakapag-hold ng more than a million. No? I think ang estimate lang nun ay 1 million to 1 million 200,000. No? Kaya yun lang po yun. No? Huwag na tayong mag-imagine ng ano pang numero. Siguro yung pag sinabing 5, kasama na dun yung mga lumalakad papunta, nandun sa top, hanggang sa Top Avenue, andun sa Bonifacio Drive, doon sa Northern End, Rojas Boulevard from the Southern End. Kasi dynamic naman yung flow ng mga tao. No? Naranasan ko nga ito 20 years ago, yung aming tahanan ay doon sa may foot of the Ayala Bridge, no? Sa may San Marcelino. As early as, parang mas maaga yata yung misa noon. Umaga, no? Hindi hapon. Lumalakad na lang kami. No? Ibig sabihin, yung control point para sa mga sasakyan ay malayo yung pag-setback for the benefit of everybody. No? Kasi kung ipilit mo man na mas lumapit ka, isipin mo naman kung paano ka makakalabas doon. No? Sa dami rin ng mga tao nagagamit ng sasakyan. Kaya nga po yung panawagan namin kanina ay magbayanihan tayo. At ang watchwords po siguro natin dito, yung kaayusan, no, at yung kaligtasan. No? Kasi kailangan po talagang pagtulungan natin yan. No? Doon sa kaayusan, yung magkusa na lang na mag-provide ng enough lead time. No? Kanina, no, mayroong mga nagtatanong halimbawa, paano yung mga media professionals natin. No? Di kung alam natin kung anong oras yung event, mag-provide tayo ng mas mahabang lead time. No? At gumawa na po tayo ng arrangements for the access of your vehicles kung kinakailangan. No? Pwede naman po natin itong pagtulungan. Huwag lang yung ora-orada, tas na magiging excited po tayo masyado, hindi po makakatulong yun. No? So yun lang po ang
thank you, sir. Thank you, Secretary Coloma. Kaya isabuhay na natin yung ano, mercy and compassion, no, na message ni Pope. No? At magandang tingnan yun, kasi kung 5 million yan, may hawak pang image ng Santo Niño yan. Nagsasayo pa ng halabira. Okay, no? So let's have more questions. Yes? A microphone, please. Introduce yourself, please.
Cecil Villarosa po from DZBB. Na-mention po ni Secretary Coloma yung preparation po on the part of media na magko-cover po ng papal visit. Maglalabas po ba kayo ng detailed route na dadaanan po ni Pope Francis for each activity?
Maglalabas po kami ng media advisory. No? Karaniwang ginagawa namin ito. Doon sa mga nagko-cover ng mga events na ganito, no? In coordination with our committee, ang kailangan lang naman po natin dito, yung sapat na impormasyon para magampanan ninyo yung inyong tungkulin. No? Kaya yun po ang aming gagawin dyan, magbibigay ng relevant information that you would need to be able to do a professional job of covering the event.
Thank you. The guy at the back, please. Thank you. Next. We have 5 more minutes for the open forum.
Good afternoon. John Neri from the Inquirer. First, point of clarification with Father Sescon. You did say that you're going to impose a network of roads in Luneta so that will allow the Pope to go around Luneta before he reaches the altar. Are we looking at a soul scenario, you know, these quadrangles of the faithful, and then, you know, with that grid of roads. If that is the case, then I have a question for Secretary Sani. There's no way we can reach 5 million. if you factor in the road network, that you'll probably be taking out space for a million people or so. So just a point of clarification first, and then if Secretary Sani can answer that.
In coordination with DPWH, we requested that concrete barriers, no, they would be lined up across the Rizal Park. Dahil nga po, yun po yung gusto talaga, sabi nung dumalaw po si Dr. Gasbari, and even in Rome that is done, before the Mass, the Pope goes around to greet the people. So he wanted really to meet everyone and to bless everyone because that will be the only chance for him. Kasi kung malayo na po sa stage, kawawa naman sila. Kaya sabi po ni Pope Francis, sana makaikot siya. Kaya in coordination with DPWH and security, from yung kalaw po, yung kalaw, Orosa, and then yung Burgos, and then Ross Boulevard, saka papasok po doon sa South Road po, going to the grandstand. So it's really, yung road pong yun ang hopefully ma-clear. No? Kasi although nung 1995, we know may mga tao yung, pero in the original plan, wala rin dapat yung tao yun eh, noong 1995. But the security then thought of tama na yung human chain. General Marquez was there also and he was sharing na yun yung original plan nila. Sabi nila, sapat na yung human chain ng mga police. But now, they learned from that and he's still the one in charge. So sabi niya, they need the help of DPWH. And that is why we will be setting up 18 giant LED walls, no? which was not around during 1995. To also para rin naman po yung mga nasa Rojas Boulevard and going to Anda Circle, ipe-preposition po yun na para kung mag-spill over po, sabi nga ni Secretary Coloma kanina na kakalat din po, hindi lang doon sa Rizal Park. So the video walls would still help the people still monitor and know what is happening. So yun po yung
Secretary Coloma, would you like to add?
Liwanagin lang natin, no, yung tanong kasi kanina, no. Ang sinabi po natin noong 1995, yun ang nailathala, naipahayag, no, na numero, no. So hindi po ako nagsabi noon, hindi si Bishop. Wala pong isa sa amin nagsabi. We're just making reference to reports at the time, no? And now we are clarifying na kung yung physical space lamang ang ating pag-uusapan, no? The kumbaga center mall of Rizal Park where the mass will take place. Ang talagang physical estimate lang doon ay 1 million to 1.2 million. Baka po pag pinag-usapan natin, the ebb and flow of the crowd, starting from the morning hanggang sa ano, doon tayo makakita ng mas malalaking numero. And if we talk of the spillover doon sa ibang mga adjoining areas. Kasi if you will take a helicopter view of the place, malaki rin naman talaga yung spread na pwedeng paglagyan ng mga tao. And I think that is one of our wishes na hanggat maaari ma-spread out pa rin natin. And katulad ng binanggit ni Father June, yung paggamit natin ng maraming LED giant screens, hopefully will ease the yung sana'y hindi maganap na surge. Kasi nakita natin sa practical na karanasan natin, the latest of which ay yung mga pagdaraos ng misa doon sa mahal na poong Nazareno. No, kinekwento nga nung Paris Priest namin kahapon, pag malapit na yung alas 7 ng umaga, whether finished or not finished, gusto nung mga deboto, umpisahan na daw yung prosesyon. So isa siguro sa mga sana'y hindi maganap ay yung ganung mga klaseng mga senaryo, no? Na wag, kaya nga dinatawag po natin yung atensyon ng lahat na pupunta ron, yung maging mahinahon po tayo, no? Maging mapagbigay sa isa't isa dahil yun lang po ang pwede nating magawa para tiyakin yung kaayusan ng buong proceedings. No? Ang sinasabi ko lang po dito, ang pamahalaan ay gagawin ang lahat ng nararapat. And as I say this, I speak of the entire government machinery, no? Both civilian and military. doon po sa aspect ng security, pinagtutulungan po ito ng Philippine National Police at ng Armed Forces of the Philippines. Yung po kasing struktura nitong Papal Visit Organizing Committee, sa hanay po ng simbahan, nandun yung CBCP, tsaka sila Cardinal Chito Tagle, sa hanay naman ng pamahalaan, si Executive Secretary Ochoa, lahat po ng mga agencies concerned hanggang sa level ng Cabinet Secretary ay involved po doon. Kaya makatitiyak kayo na there is no stone being left unturned in the effort to achieve yung pong orderliness, yung seamless flow of events, and above all, the security of our people who expectedly will come in the thousands, in the hundreds and thousands para po sa buong kaganapang ito na dapat nating pagtulungan.
Siyempre, huwag po natin kalimutan sa isang mega crowd gathering tulad ng Luneta Mass, no? The classic means of communication, let us bring radios, no? Para for smooth communication of what's going on, especially the mass. Let's have more, three more questions. Yes, ma'am?
Good afternoon. I'm Baby Nebrida, Mary's Army Media Movement. I'd like to address this question to Bishop Mylo. Since there will be millions, probably thousands, receiving communion, I'd like to know if there are priests available for confession also in the ground of Luneta. Thank you very much.
Well, this is the event of Luneta is actually the Luneta Mass of the Holy Father, no? And basically, that is the highest form of liturgy that was specified for that event, no? Now, if to prepare for the Holy Father's coming, we have already campaigned, no, that we make the proper spiritual preparation in your parishes to go to confession. If in the process you are there and there will be priests even before the Mass, you might want to approach them, no, during that event, no. But I think as best as we can, given the order of events, no, we want to highlight the Eucharistic liturgy, no. So we can do the confession even before January 18, no? So, however, if you still, like in any parish, sometimes, no, when we celebrate Mass, after the Mass, there are people who approach us, no, we make ourselves available, that can be done, no?
Thank you, Bishop. Mas maganda before the event, kasi sa pagdating ng Luneta Mass, sa dami ng tao, public confession na yun. Yes, ma'am. Two more.
This is a question for Bishop Mylo and Secretary Coloma. I'm Jean Castaneda from ABS-CBN. Sir, pwede ho kayang ibigay ninyo ng maaga? The sooner we get a copy of the map, the better. Para po masiguro nga maayos, no? With everything already identified, saan yung portalet, saan yung VD wall, saan yung mga areas na gusto na pwedeng puntahan ng tao at kung saan naman bawal. And then even the first aid stations, baka nga sir kulang po yun sa DOH, baka dapat ho dagdagan. And then especially yung VD wall, yung location kasi ng VD wall will actually kind of estimate hanggang saan yung tao. Dahil kung wala na silang mapanood, hindi na sila pipirmi doon. And then another thing po, nung 1995 may mga nag-camp out ng mga tao doon sa Luneta. So paano ho ngayon? Pwede ba mag-camp out? Ibabawal nyo ba? Kailan magsisimula yung pagbabawal kung meron man at saang areas?
Upon the instruction po ng PSG and PNP, wala pong papahintulutang, they will secure the area days before. And wala pong papahintulutan pong mag-camping or doon matulog na po para po maging maayos ang lahat po. Bubuksan lang po or papayagan po talagang pumasok ang mga tao alas 6 po ng umaga. Bukas po doon pupunta
January 18.
January 18 po.
Alas 6 ng umaga.
Alas 6 po ng umaga po. Yan lang po ang tuloy-tuloy. By doon po sa may grandstand, by 1 o'clock, wala na rin po. Kahit may mga passes, may ID, hindi na rin po sila papahintulutang pumasok sa secured area ng grandstand. Dahil yun na po yung pinaka-immediate preparation for the coming of the Holy Father. Na po.
So 6 a.m. until 1 p.m.
Apa.
Only for the secured area.
Apo, yung by 6 a.m. po, pati yung public areas po, actually, will be restricted no, the night before. Until 6 a.m., bubuksan na po yun. Yung for everyone po, hanggang Rizal Park, yung Lapu-Lapu, and then yung may Carabao po, yun, bubuksan lang po yun, 6 o'clock ng umaga po.
And then, Secretary Coloma, would you like to add more? Okay na.
Sa hanay po ng media, no? Gagawin po namin ang nararapat para mabigyan kayo ng timely information. Tulad ng sinishare ko kanina, merong tumawag na media organization na yung tanggapan daw nila nandun sa loob ng restricted zone. Eh sabi ko, madali namang pag-usapan, makatuwira naman yung ating security. No? Basta lang mag-communicate tayo sa isa't isa and let's make advanced preparations para hindi nga yung ura-urada. Mahirap lang kasi kung, halimbawa, 3:30 na yung misa, nagpupumili tayong pumasok doon sa hindi pwede, at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, mas mahirap tayong makapag-respond doon sa ganun. But if there is advance notice, then we have more lead time to facilitate access, no? Even doon sa mga restricted areas. No? For example din, ano, yung sa airport related events, no, which are the departure, the arrival, pagkatapos yung arrival and departure for and from Tacloban, tapos yung departure, nakapaglabas na yung CAAP, no, tsaka yung MIAA, Manila International Airport Authority, ng detailed guidelines tungkol dyan. Uulitin na lang siguro yan a few days before, no, for the benefit of those that will be using the airport. No? Pero in general, ang mga patakaran lang is ipapaalam kung hanggang saan yung vehicle access. No? Ipapaalam din kung ano yung mga controlled hours natin para makapag-prepare yung mga dapat na pumunta doon sa mga lugar na yun. No? At clearly delineated naman kasi yung responsibility ng mga security officers at the designated points. No? Kaya kailangan lang po yung makiisa tayo sa kanila. They already have made the necessary preparations. No? Makiisa lang tayo para maging maginhawa para sa karamihan.
Last two, yes ma'am. And the gentleman. Okay.
The question. Microphone, please.
Thank you. I'm NJ Wieland. I'm covering for National Catholic Reporter. I want to ask maybe Father Arada, or I don't know who. I want to ask two things. One is, how can the people participate, given that, in the liturgy, are you going to hand out guides, or will this just be flashed? No, but I mean, how can it be truly participative and not just a spectacle to watch? Then also, I wanted to ask whoever, how is the Pope exiting? Is he exiting by land or how? Don't laugh. Don't say secret.
So for the songs to be sung during the Mass, our parishes are already familiarizing themselves with all the songs. And then for the liturgy guides, of course, we will flash them on the LED screens. Living with Christ and Sambuhay will publish liturgy guides. So I think everybody will be given liturgy guides. So, yes, about St. Paul Fathers promised that they will publish more than a million, I think more than 2 million, and can be downloaded from the internet. So,
okay. Yes, sir.
Hindi ko sasabihin secret. Ang masasabi ko lang po ay ito. Lahat ng posibleng senaryo ay pinag-aaralan. At ang layunin ay tiyakin yung kaligtasan ng Santo Papa. At yung kapasidad din niya na makapag-interact in a meaningful way with the faithful, which I think is his overall guideline. Diba? Sa lahat ng kanyang pagkilos, ipinahiwatig niya na gusto niya maging visible and accessible. No? Ginagalang po, igagalang po yung kagustuhan din niyang yan. No? Kaya po pinaghahandaan ng puspusan ng ating mga otoridad kung paano po matutupad ang layunin ito.
Thank you. The last, yes sir?
I'm Bullet Marquez from Associated Press po. In terms of media access, how close can we get to the Pope? Meron bang pool arrangement and tapos well, meron ba tayong special sort of entrance for the media?
Naranasan nyo naman siguro yung mga coverages sa Luneta, no? For example, yung presidential inauguration, yung mga ganun. Meron na tayong predetermined positions, no, para sa mga cameras, no, para sa mga videographic equipment. Meron ding media box na ilalaan doon. Kaya lang, dahil libo-libo yung posibleng darating, we will have to determine kung ano yung allowable number, no, do sa mga stations. And let's take note na meron din tayong media center, which is the 10th of Manila Hotel, na iilang metro lang ang layo nun doon sa mismong altar. No? So kahit yung media ay nandun lang sa loob ng media center, tiyak na meron silang live coverage din naman doon. No? So yung mga hindi kailangan ang physical presence nila mismo doon sa pinakamalapit, they can have it alternatively doon sa media center. No? Ramdam na ramdam pa rin nila yung ambience, no? Dahil nandoon lang yun, no? na malapit sa center of the event itself. No? Pero yung para sa katulad mo na merong pangailangan na maging malapit, eh meron naman tayong mga photographer's box, videographer's box, reporter's box, subject to reasonable rules on pooling, no? And the allocation of numbers per media outfit.
Thank you for our...
Idadagdag ko lang.
Yeah. Additional.
Idadagdag ko lang po, no? Siguro makakatulong po na ipaliwanag na po nung ilang mga press briefing nung tinanong po ito. Alam naman po natin na yung bawat event ay yung iba'y may mga restrictions, no, dahil sa limited space ng event, no. Sa totoo lang, ang pinakamalaking space ay ang Luneta, no. Kaya kung kayo po ay nagpa-accredit, no, sa ating website, no, ay maliwanag din po yung rules and regulations po doon kung saan niyo gustong magpa magpumunta, no. At yan po ang inaayos po natin ngayon para meron po kayong as best as we can representation. Kaso siguro we are also asking cooperation from all of you, no, na let us help each other in this events that will happen. Kasi if you try to look at the many people, the many press people who have accredited, nag-meeting lang po kami nasa 4,000 na po kayo, no? Parang capacity na yata ng tatlong simbahan na misa na po yun. Isipin nyo, media, kayo pa lang po yan, no? So, sana po maunawaan nyo kung sakaling nag-allocate po kami for your particular entity, no, press entity, no, media entity, na ito lang po ang pwedeng maibigay given na your request, no. So so we hope, no, that you can understand it. Alam niyo naman po ang main media center pa rin natin ay Diamond Hotel. Nandun po kayo, nandun yung vamp, ipinaliwanag na rin po na gabi-gabi magkakaroon po ng press conference doon at may mga representations po kayo. Ang capacity po ng ballroom doon ay around 300 lang po. Kung ang Vatican media personnel po o press ay around 50 ang a-attend given their 80. So we can accommodate as much as 250, no, to enter there. But we will try to have a live hookup sa Manila Hotel. Now we're trying to work on that, no, para kung may mga tanong, no, pag nagbigay na po ng perspectives o considerations si Father Lombardi o yung ibang mga nasa panel, ay magkaroon po ng interaction po tayo, no? We're trying our best kung po pwede pong magawa po yon.
Thank you, Bishop Mylo. In the interest of time,
eto na po, i-announce ko na po.
In the interest of time, we'll be ending the open forum and we would like to thank you, media partners, and our panelists from the church and the government. Now we will have the announcements. Bishop Mylo, announcement.
Ito na po yung, tinatanong niyo po yung release of media accredited IDs, no? Ito na po yung announcement, no? Ang release dates po natin ay January 12 to 14, 2015. Ang reason po nito, pinush, ano namin, no, forward, kasi po for security purposes din po, no? January 12 to 13, IDs will be released for local media alphabetically per news organization. Okay, ha? No, if I may repeat that, January 12 to 13, IDs will be released for local media alphabetically per news organization. Oho. Ito pong hindi po, patapusin niyo muna ako sandali. Hindi pa ho tapos yung ano. Para humakompleto lang ho. Excited ho talaga tayo lahat para sa pagdating na Santo Papa. January 14 naman po, IDs will be released for foreign, church, and freelance media alphabetically per news organizations. I will repeat that January 14, IDs will be released for foreign, church, and freelance media alphabetically per news organization. Dito po sa GHQ, no? Dito po kung saan tayo nando, dito po i-release. Now, may we request all media representatives to fill up the sheet that is being routed. Ito po, ito po yung dinidistribute po natin. We need the names and contact details of the person or persons in charge of the papal visit coverage of your respective media entities. They should be the persons responsible for assigning specific people to a specific papal for the specific papal visit venues, no? That will facilitate, no, our release, no? Kaya kung yung pong ilalagay niyo pong contact na makakatulong na po yan, no, para dun sa ating release po ng IDs, no? Kaya yung mga contact numbers yan, makakapag-coordinate na po tayo. At least mababawasan na po natin, no, yung iba pong mga requirements na kailangan po nila.
Yung foreign po ba, foreign na abroad o foreign na dito?
Eh, basta ho nakalagay ho dito eh, foreign. So, meron hong category yung inayos po nila eh. So, pag sinabi hong foreign, nung nag-register po sila, meron pong ispinesify dun sa kanila. Malalaman po. Kinategorize po namin, sinimplify po namin yan.
Okay. Thank you. Yeah. Thank you, Bishop Mylo. So, of course, after the press briefing, we can continue our questions. No, but for the sake of the information of everybody, please fill up the form that we're distributing. And of course, if you need resource persons, kung gusto niyo po ng resource persons from the church, meron po tayong official resource persons. I'll be giving you the first set of 26 individuals, priests and religious. They have their expertise in different fields na na-orient na for the papal visit, and they know all the activities. So we will give you a copy. First come, first serve na lang. Complete information po ito. And then, sabi ng Radio Veritas, please inform the people to bring radios para we can continue the proper communication and what's happening in the different activities of the Luneta.